When we started SSY, I too did not have all this knowledge. But God has slowly, slowly given very high knowledge. When we started SSY, we only knew about how to become more and more happy day by day. I did not know how to become more and more loving day by day. I did not know how to become more and more wealthy. I did not know how to have more and more beauty around me. I did not know. Gradually knowledge has come. Now I will teach it to you. It has taken 30, 40 years. I have done my sadhana. You too do your sadhana. For me to discover it took a long time. Because there is no teacher for this. Now after I discover, it is very easy for me to give it to you. But you have to do the sadhana. Simply understanding will not help. Now, you see, for example, Newton's laws of motion. Many of you must have heard of Newton's laws of motion. You have gone through in 8th standard, Newton's laws of motion. Second law of motion, F is equal to ma. All of you have gone through F is equal to ma. Even if you are given 1,000 years, can you discover F is equal to ma by yourself? You will discover by yourself. I bet nobody probably in this room can get it. Even after 1,000 years thinking by yourself, you cannot get it. It is very difficult to get. Once Newton understood and got it, now all of us can understand or not easily. This is the blessings from Newton to all of us. Should we be grateful to Newton or not? Einstein, E is equal to mc square. Grateful, they are also great gurus. We are borrowing knowledge from them. That is aparagnana. Now, what I am giving you, love, happiness, wealth, these are all paragnana. This, by understanding, is not enough. You have to experience. You have to do the sadhana to get this thing. Just hearing aham brahmasmi, I am everything, I am always, is not enough. You have to experience it. There are two aspects to life. One is the spirit, another one is matter. You can cook a food. You can cook food. It tastes very nice. Now, whether the person who has prepared the food, whether he is happy or not, depends on his spirit. The person who eats the food may be happy, but the person who is preparing the food, whether he is happy or not, the more and more happy that person who is preparing the food, his food will become more and more tasty. Otherwise, if that cook has no spirit, why I am doing? Do something, give. How? The food will turn into shit more and more. Okay. Not tasty. Going to work is all shit, but going to work happily is fantastic. Most people in this world are going to work, not to work. Most children are going to school, not to study. They are going there only because of pressure, only because they have to get marks, not because they want to go to school. Almost every child is very happy when it is holidays and they don't have to go to school. Most employees are very happy when they are given holiday, paid holiday, are very happy. Most of the people are going to work, not to work. They are trying to find out how not to work and get the money. They require 25 supervisors, attendance sheets, because no spirit, no understanding. So the whole world is working ulta. They seem to go to work, but actually they are not going to work. So, now we are going to enjoy our life. Okay. Do you want to enjoy your life or do you want to be miserable right now? See, we are in a very fantastic age. This particular teaching has never been around, Even from the Vedic and Upanishads, this teaching has not been around. At the best, the only teaching that was available was how to be happy for no reason. Okay? This is called Atmanubhav. Atmanubhav. Now I'll tell you about these answers, okay? Slowly. Because most of you don't know about these answers. You have never been trained in the spirit. You have only been trained in the matter. This whole thing is about spirit. We will go step by step understanding this, what is this knowledge. Now, what is the origin of happiness? Many people will say, they don't know origin of happiness. They say, happiness is getting some more money. Happiness is getting married to this particular girl. Okay. They can say, I experienced happiness like this, but they don't know where the root of happiness is. Where is the root of happiness? Root of happiness is not in doing something. Root of happiness is in silence. Root of happiness is in silence. Now let me define what is silence. Sitting quietly, seriously like this is not silence. That is seriousness. It will not work. Sitting without moving is not silence. Praying to God is not silence. Still you are talking now. So, I can tell you, origin of happiness is in silence, okay? Now my work is to take you to that silence. Silence is not being disturbed by anything outside or inside is called silence. The more you are not disturbed by outside or inside, the more developed human being you are. When you are not at all disturbed by anything happening outside or inside, it is called sthitapragna sthiti, called jivan mukti, liberated from life, from the troubles of life. Not disturbed by anything outside or inside is called silence. The more silence you have, the more you are not disturbed by what is happening. Everybody gets disturbed beyond a point. So that point is going on increasing and you are not at all disturbed. Even if you die, you are not disturbed. Huh? Initially you will learn how to go into silence with your eyes closed. For 15 minutes, how you can go into silence without being disturbed by anything outside or inside. This is the first learning you have to do. One more thing, I forgot in the middle. Those of you who don't come to any of these sessions for whatever reason, you have to pay 5,000 rupees fine. We have given you 2 dates for each. If you are unable to come for one, you must come for the other. We will keep attendance. You must give 5,000 rupees if you don't come. This is a fine. And it goes as a donation to RSVK. Okay. Because many people come lapda. They say, and then they don't come. I couldn't come. This holiday, you know, Uparayana was there. That marriage was there. That person happened. I don't care who happened. If you don't come, you have to pay 5,000, okay? Best is don't come, okay? This is not 11-day, 21-day program. This is now 48 years program. Now, this is only I'm asking for 6 months, about 6 months program. This 6 months will definitely make you quite firm in your sadhana. Okay? It is not, you get distracted very easily. That's why you have to do. It is not just learning once. I will tell you more why all these things are required. Okay? Now, what is happiness? Origin of happiness is silence. The more silent you are, the more happy you are. Happiness is not for getting anything. It's for being in silence. Okay? For no reason you are happy. More silent you are, the more happy you are. It is not for any reason. And you don't become silent by trying to do something. Silence you have never gotten by doing something. By doing nothing only you get silence. Not for getting something. Not for giving something, not for getting something, not for doing something. All doing is a karma prapancha. All non-doing is moksha prapancha. One is material, another one is spirit. Moksha prapancha is non-doing. All doing is karma prapancha. Doing and getting. To get this, you have to do this. To get that, you have to do this. Here, what is there to get? Nothing to get. Huh? What you have to do? Nothing to do. What you will be? Silent. Fantastic, no? Huh? This is about silence. This is not about doing anything. The more and more you are able to be silent, the more and more happy you will become automatically. Huh? For no reason. As sthita prajnatva, as that state where you are not disturbed, goes on increasing the level, you will become more and more happy. Right now, many people, if they are sitting and a dog barks, bow, 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 everybody gets disturbed. Huh? When you are not disturbed by this bow, 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 huh? You have attained some state. When it is very loud also, you are not disturbed. More. It is your level of not being disturbed that decides that how happy you are. Okay? Now, how do you become more and more happy day by day? How? By going into silence, more and more, you become more and more happy every day. You understand? Huh? Possible or not? You understand? Before you did not understand how I can become more and more happy. You did not know. I am telling you, you can become more and more happy by what? More and more silence. Possible or not? This is called tapasya. Not doing anything, taking time not to do anything is called sadhana. Not doing something is sadhana. Taking time not to do anything is called sadhana. Sadhana is very easy. Life is very hot. Doing work, doing life is very hot. Non-doing is very easy. Non-doing is sadhana. Shifting your life from effort to effortlessness is called sadhana. Why you should do sadhana? If it is giving more perspiration, more perspiration is not sadhana. Your life is going to be less and less perspiration, more and more joyful. This is sadhana. Now, what is sadhana? Shift from effort to effortlessness is sadhana. Life becoming more and more easy is sadhana. Life becoming more and more difficult means foolishness. Okay. Most of the people, their life is becoming more and more difficult. More and more difficult. Children, very beautiful. Children are very beautiful. Very, very beautiful. Why? No strain. They are enjoying life. They look beautiful. Any child looks beautiful. Any child is beautiful in the world. Because no worry, no. Huh? Playful, joyful, nice. So even when you start becoming playful, joyful, you will also look beautiful. Okay? You understand? Lipstick is not going to make you beautiful. Pond's Lakme cream is not going to give you beautiful. What is going to make you beautiful? Enjoying life makes you look beautiful. Correct or not? How you look beautiful? Enjoying life. When you are enjoying life, there is no strain. You look beautiful. No cream is required. So, I have answered the fourth question. Now, first question, everybody understand? How you become more and more happy every day? By going into more and more silent. Once you become totally undisturbed, you are the most beautiful face in the world. Okay? Now, love. Where is the origin of love? Most of you don't know about love. Huh? Only you think a girl falling in love with another boy is love. You don't know about love. What is love? Where is the origin of love? But just because you understood where is the origin of happiness, you are not happy. Don't worry. Unless you experience silence, you are not going to be happy. Unless you do the sadhana of silence, you are not going to be happy. Knowing that happiness is in silence doesn't make you happy. Knowing is not enough. You must experience that state where you are silent, then you will experience happiness by yourself. Correct, no? Now, love. Love. Where is the origin of love? Whatever I am telling you, these answers now, don't tell it to anybody. Simply. Because they think they know the answer. What is the use of knowing the answer? Bugger has not gone into silence. Okay? Only by going into silence and understanding how to go into deeper levels of silence, you become this. So your first level is to understand and go into 15-minute silence. When you come for AMC, you start understanding how to go into deeper level of silence. With the eyes open, how to be in that silence. Walking, how to be in these sessions, okay? Learning about that. When you go to the retreats, we train you more and more and more and more. Okay? Silence. Happiness is in where? Silence. Happiness is where? Silence. It is not in getting married. People get married. After 10 days, they say, "Ayyo, why I got married?" And then after 1 year, they are prepared to run away from the marriage. They are looking how to run away from this. That is not where happiness is. Where is happiness? Silence. Now, love. Where is love? Where is the origin of love? (Clears tell you. Love. Production of love. Love happens when a person is a nobody. When you become a nobody, when the other person is a nobody, when two people, nobodies, meet, tremendous amount of love is produced. What is happening to many of us, which you don't really understand, it will take you some time to get all this distinction. See, you are a somebody. What do you mean by somebody? Okay, you think you are a Brahmin, for example. You are a somebody. You think you are a Hindu, that is a somebody. You think you are a Muslim, you are somebody. You think I am Indian, I am somebody. I am Pakistani, somebody. I am American, somebody. Okay? Now, Indians get along well with Indians. Pakistanis get along well with Pakistanis. Hindus get along well with Hindus. Muslims get along well with Muslims. Correct or not? You naturally turn to in this direction. Why? Because this somebody and you somebody, you have very similar thinking, very similar habits. So it is easy for you to mix together and be together. So you seek out those people who make your life easy. Correct? As a somebody, you are comfortable only with other somebodies who are similar to you. Correct now? You are eating Andhra food. When you go to Karnataka, they prepare sambar differently. Oh, you don't like. Whenever you see Andhra meals, you will run over and eat. Because you are used to it. It is comfortable for you. You do it. Punjabis will go to Punjabi food. Maharashtrians want Maharashtrian food. Why? Because they are used to that particular thing. Whatever you are used to, you are comfortable. Whatever you are not used to, you become uncomfortable. You have to learn how to be in that environment, so it becomes uncomfortable. Okay? So, as a somebody, you are comfortable only with certain things. But as a nobody, you are comfortable with everyone. Yeah. Sadhana means going from being somebody to being nobody is called sadhana. Why you do what you do? Observe. Why you do what you do? You do everything to protect your identity. Your whole life is only about protecting your identity. As Indians, we want to protect India. As Hindus, you want to protect Hindus. As a doctor, you want to protect doctors. Among doctors, if you are an Ayurvedic doctor, you will protect Ayurveda doctors. Why you do whatever you do? Only to protect yourself. If you are a Hindu, you pass by a temple, automatically you will do namaskar like this. If you are a Christian, as soon as you see the cross, you will start doing. Understand? What you are doing is automatic because of your somebodyness. When you don't do anything, you become nobody. When you are nothing to protect, you don't have to do anything. Struggle is only when you want to protect yourself. When you are a zero, you have nothing to protect. You can enjoy life, not work. As a somebody, your life is a struggle. As a nobody, your life is a joy. This is a shift from somebodyness to nobodyness. A person who is not disturbed by anybody, he can get along with anybody. Oh, being nobody, when you interact with others, being nobody, then you generate love. As soon as you become somebody, then you just generate conflict. You will generate conflict. You become serious. The more and more you are identified and become somebody, you become more and more serious fellow. Your nationality, your religion, these things are buggers that will make you a stupid fellow, serious fellow, kill others, all these things will happen. Because of wrong understanding, wrong way of living, instead of joy of life, you are killing life. Okay. All religions ultimately want you to become zero, but instead you become a big demon. Become a big Hindu demon, big Islam demon, big Christian demon. Yeah. Joy of life is gone. Serious fellow, dangerous fellow. Very dedicated. You become very dedicated to Hinduism. You are a more dangerous fellow. You become very dedicated to Islam. You become a fool. Dangerous people are produced by dedicating themselves to becoming big somebodies. Being nobody who can get along with everyone is religion. If you say, I only get along with Hindus, you are a rascal. You are a very dangerous fellow. From somebody to nobody, from somebody to nobody is elevated state. Happy life. Okay. From being big somebody to being a zero, being a child. Enjoy life. Okay. This happens by giving time for silence, for being nobody, interacting with nobody. That nobodyness itself develops through silence. I guarantee when you come to AMC, you will find extraordinary love between all of you together. Extraordinary love will develop between all of you. When two nobodies come together for doing nothing, then love develops. Okay. Where is the origin of love? Nobodiness is origin of love. Every child is loved by everyone. The smaller the child, the more they love. It has no somebodiness. As it becomes and become more and more somebody, they become more and more dangerous. Nobody likes to talk to them. How you become more and more loving day by day? By being nobody. Doing sadhana, to be nobody, by doing nothing, you become more and more loving. Now, third question. Where is the origin of wealth? But I am not talking, I will give you that experience. Then only it is valid. Not simply talking, you will experience. Okay. First you will experience, silence is God. Silence is happiness. Next you will experience, love is God. Love is God. Everybody tells you, love. Where does love simply come in or what? You can talk all you want, but the real love will develop only through sadhana of being nobody. Not being able to be with somebody is called hatred. Tolerating somebody, even though they are different, you can get along with them somehow, is called tolerance. But you like somebody and you be with them, this is called friendship. When you are able to be with another person as if he doesn't exist other than you, you are one and the same, that is called love. We will know more about this. Different kind of sambandhas, different levels. But right now, simple sample is good enough for you to little bit understand. You will go deeper and deeper into this. When you love each other fully, then you give everything of yourself to the other person. Other person gives everything to you. Huh? Then you become rich. You don't become rich by working hard. You become rich by winning their heart. Okay. Only donkeys work hard. Most of other donkeys working hard. You never become rich by working hard. You become rich by winning another person's heart. Your real wealth is not your bank balance. Your real wealth is how many people love you. That is your real wealth. How many people care for you? How many people will give their life for you? That is your wealth. You are having crores of rupees, but nobody likes you. Everybody wants to throw stones at you. But most of the people, they create their own jail. Because if you are very, very rich, other people will come and steal. So what you have to do is put a very, very big gate and two dogs and three rifles and imprison yourself inside. Okay? Donkeys. Where is the origin of wealth? When you share what you have with others, with love, you become rich. Richer and richer day by day. The more you share with more and more people, whatever you have, the more and more rich you become. If prema is not there, this exchange will not happen. This prema is the lubricant for the thing to work. Without love, you are protecting yourself. You are not offering yourself. Only when you offer, when the exchange takes place, then both of you become rich. Example, he has got wood, you have got rice. You cannot eat rice by itself. You have to cook the food. He cannot eat the wood. He requires the rice to cook the wood. Correct, to cook the rice and eat. He has got wood, you have got rice. Unless you exchange, both of you will remain stopped. You require his wood and he requires your rice. Only when you exchange, you become rich. Economy is nothing but rate of exchange. Rate of exchange. If the rate of exchange increases, everybody becomes rich. If the rate of exchange stops, everybody becomes poor. Now, I give you one more example. You are having one house. He is having one house. He is having one house. All the three of you love each other. And then you say, my house is your house. Your house is my house. Then what happens? How many houses you have got now? Three houses. Is it real or not? Real or unreal? Real. Huh? Because you have the use of the three houses. All the three of you have now got three houses. Before you had only one house. All the three, have you grown rich or not? Guaranteed. If you keep whatever you have to yourself, you become poor. If you give whatever you have with other person, then you become rich. You got lot of gold, lot of gold, lot of gold. What use is it? You can't eat the gold. Unless somebody wants to buy the gold, it is of no use. So, unless the exchange takes place, there is no wealth. And love is the lubricant for the exchange. Now, all of you want to become more and more wealthy day by day? Or you want to remain with only one house? How many houses I have? You know, huh? How many houses I have? Millions of houses I have. Not one, not two. I have millions of houses. Why? Why? because I'm prepared to offer 100% of myself. So all my thing is yours, all yours is mine. People who are conjures, they don't want to give their house, they become poor. Here you get rich by giving, not by taking. In the karma world, you take. In moksha world, you give. Okay. Which one you want to do? For this, what is required? Love. For love to develop, what is required? Silence. Know this connection. From happiness to love to wealth. Many people think that if they have money, then they will become happy. They are working their ass like a donkey. They don't get any happiness. The shift, what is this program? Shift from being somebody to nobody. From effort to effortlessness. From being poor to becoming rich. Effortlessly, day by day, more and more rich, more and more love, more and more happiness. Is this what you want? Huh? What is the usual karma by the other? Less and less happiness, less and less friends, and less and less wealth. Jai Gurudev. Now we will go more into more of this, but today I've given you the answer or not? Got the answer, but simply understanding is not enough. Practice. Now I will take you slowly to higher and higher levels of silence. Okay? Higher and higher levels of love. Higher and higher levels of wealth. Higher and higher levels of beauty. Huh? There is one thing beyond that, but you will not understand, so I'm not telling you. Okay? That after you develop, I will tell you more. Okay? These are five wealths we have, five fundamental education. The first education is called silence. It is to do with Akasha Tattva. Second love is to do with Vayu Tattva, Hanuman. The third has got to do with fire, with Agni Tattva. It gives you Lakshmi, gives you wealth. The fourth one has got to do with Jala. Jala means test. Test has got to do with beauty, wonder. Okay? The fifth one has got to do with Prithvi. With Prithvi, you will get enormous power to change any place, even Kachada place, into a Sugandha place. From Gandha to Sugandha is the Prithvi. So we will discuss more about that, but this is too much. For example, Gandhiji converted a Durgandha into Sugandha. Mother Teresa converts Durgandha into Sugandha. That is why they are very great people. You must also learn how to become that great by working on each tattva. First one is Akasha Tattva, 3 years. Next one is Vayu Tattva, love and leadership, 6 years. Now, next tattva is Agni Tattva. Here, you become rich. It takes 12 years. After that, Jala Tattva, you will be able to construct Taj Mahal. Not an ordinary house, Taj Mahal. This one requires 24 years. To convert a Durgandha place into a Sugandha place takes 48 years, Satna. So this is the way that we progress. Okay? You all understand now, huh? Vayu Tattva, Akasha Tattva, Vayu Tattva, Agni Tattva, Jala Tattva and Prithvi Tattva. Okay? We are going to go slowly, one by one, into these lessons. First is silence and happiness. Second one, love and leadership. Third one, wealth. Producing wealth for everybody. Wherever you go, the place will become wealthy. You also become wealth. This is called Vaishya, Vaishya Tattva. Second one is Kshatriya Tattva. First one is Brahmanatva. First lesson is Brahmana. Second lesson is Kshatriya. Third lesson is Vaishya. Fourth lesson is Shudra. Fifth lesson is Aspruṣya. Okay, we will go into this later. This is Prithvi Tattva. A person who has mastered Prithvi Tattva definitely will get a Nobel Prize. Okay. We will learn about all these things as we go. Okay. Jai Gurudev. Simply because you come here, we don't have to accept you. Okay. Simply because you come and you don't participate, I am going to remove you. Simply because you come here, I need not accept you.
If you feel like scratching, you can scratch, but don't open your eyes. It will take a few minutes for the silence, for the whole body to become very, very calm and silent. Don't worry. Just be with whatever that is going on without resisting. Now just be with the silence. Don't expect anything. Keep your eyes closed. Child, playing everywhere, being everywhere. was a being a wonderful child, loving everyone, being with everyone. Without putting yourself important, just being a child with everyone. See yourself loving everyone, serving everyone. Just enjoying yourself, whatever you are doing. Just see yourself doing whatever you do, playfully, joyfully, knowing that nothing is important. Plan and be with everyone. What you accomplish, what you get is not important. See yourself being in love with everyone, whoever is there with you. See yourself enjoying everything you do, just like a small child enjoys everything. See yourself giving whatever you are having to everyone around you, just sharing everything you have. Just see yourself being loved by everyone around you. Srinivasa, being a free bird, loved and taken care everywhere, wherever you go, you are welcome. Just see yourself being with everybody, seeing God in everyone. Being looked after like a god, wherever you go, you are a sweet, wonderful child of God. See yourself going all around the world, sharing whatever you have, just being in love with everyone. See yourself enjoying creating beautiful things and offering it to everyone. See yourself learning to do many, many things, enjoying and exploring the world. See yourself having hundreds of homes all around the world. Wherever you go, you are invited. You have nothing to get, nothing to lose. You are simply a wonderful child moving around. Wherever you sit, you attract love and everybody is with you. You are able to take care of hundreds of people. The whole of this country welcomes such wonderful children of God. Everyone who wants to be with God is welcomed everywhere. All the ashrams are waiting for such wonderful children to come and be there. This whole country is waiting for such children of God to come and to be with them. How much you have studied, what you have done is not important. Just being a wonderful child of God, loving everyone, is all that is required for you to live a very happy life. The whole world is yours. You can learn many, many things, but first you will have lots of love, lots of happiness. The earlier you are with Guruji, the better. The younger you are, the better. There is no need to work and sweat. Life is wonderful when you simply love everyone, be with everyone. You can create lots and lots of wealth by being a wonderful child of God. You are going on creating and offering and receiving more and more every day with lots of love from everyone. See yourself being wealthy, having so many things without effort. Now, offer yourself to the person sitting opposite to you. Just be with this wonderful child of God in front of you. Just take the hands of your partner. Just be with the partner, offering all of your love, all of yourself to this partner. Just be with this wonderful child of God in front of you. Now, slowly open your eyes and just be with your partner. give a big hug to your partner. Now all of you stand up and give a big hug to everyone.
Gopala Gopala
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 Sabke dil mein samaya hai Gopala Gopala
Sabke dil mein samaya
सबके दिल में समाया है गोपाला गोपाला
सबके दिल में समाया है गोपाला गोपाला
गोपाला गोपाला
गोपाला गोपाला
गोपाला गोपाला
गोपाला गोपाला
गोपाला गोपाला
मुरली मनोहर सबसे प्यारा है 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 गोपाला गोपाला
Thank you. गोपाला गोपाला
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 सबका प्यारा नंद दुलारा है 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 गोपाला गोपाला
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 राधा जी का प्रेम दीवाना है 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 गोपाला गोपाला
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 रास रचैया गोपी संग नाचे गोपाला गोपाला
रास रचैया गोपी संग नाचे
रास रचैया गोपी संग नाचे गोपाला गोपाला
रास रचैया गोपी संग नाचे गोपाला गोपाला
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 यशोदा जी का नवनीत छोरा है 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 गोपाला
गोपाला 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 गोपाला
छोड़ा मैंने जगे सारा है गोपाला गोपाला छोड़ा मैंने जग ये सारा है गोपाला गोपाला
छोड़ा मैंने जग ये सारा है गोपाला गोपाला
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 गोपाला गोपाला परमानंद परमेश्वर प्यारा है गोपाला गोपाला
परमानंद परमेश्वर प्यारा है गोपाला गोपाला
परमानंद परमेश्वर प्यारा है। गोपाला गोपाला
परमानंद परमेश्वर प्यारा है।
गोपाला गोपाला
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 दर्शन मांगे भक्त तुम्हारे है। गोपाला गोपाला
दर्शन मांगे भक्त तुम्हारे है।
दर्शन मांगे भक्त तुम्हारे है। गोपाला गोपाला
दर्शन मांगे भक्त तुम्हारे है। गोपाला गोपाला
गोपाला
गोपाला गोपाला
गोपाला गोपाला
गोपाला गोपाला
गोपाला गोपाला
गोपाला गोपाला
गोपाला गोपाला गोपाला गोपाला
गोपाला गोपाला
सबके दिल में समाया है। गोपाला गोपाला
सबके दिल में समाया है। गोपाला गोपाला
सबका प्यारा नंद दुलारा है। गोपाला गोपाला
सबका प्यारा नंद दुलारा है। गोपाला गोपाला
राधा जी का प्रेम दीवाना है। गोपाला गोपाला
राधा जी का प्रेम दीवाना है। गोपाला गोपाला
रास रचैया गोपी संग नाचे। गोपाला गोपाला
रास रचैया गोपी संग नाचे। गोपाला गोपाला
यशोदा जी का नवनीत चोरा है। गोपाला गोपाला
यशोदा जी का नवनीत चोरा है। गोपाला गोपाला
छोड़ा मैंने जग ये सारा है। गोपाला गोपाला
छोड़ा मैंने जग ये सारा है। गोपाला गोपाला
दर्शन मांगे भक्त तुम्हारे है। गोपाला गोपाला
दर्शन मांगे भक्त तुम्हारे है। गोपाला गोपाला
परमानंद परमेश्वर प्यारा है। गोपाला गोपाला
परमानंद परमेश्वर प्यारा है। गोपाला
गोपाला
गोपाला गोपाला
गोपाला गोपाला
गोपाला गोपाला
गोपाला गोपाला
गोपाला गोपाला
गोपाला गोपाला
गोपाला गोपाला
गोपाला गोपाला
गोपाला गोपाला
गोपाला गोपाला
गोपाला गोपाला
गोपाला गोपाला रे नंदन गोपाला
गोपाला गोपाला रे देवकी नंदन गोपाला।
गोपाला गोपाला रे देवकी नंदन गोपाला।
गोपाला गोपाला रे देवकी नंदन गोपाला।
रिवर्सल ऑफ हार्ट डिजीज द रोल ऑफ SSY इन क्योरिंग हार्ट पेशेंट्स is aptly described by none other than Dr. Jagdish Hiremath, a leading cardiologist in Pune. He applied the science of SSY on a selected group of his heart patients for a study. He presented his findings at the International Cardiology Conference at New Delhi in 1999. The following comparative study of the effect of SSY against the effect of a similar lifestyle program conducted by Dr. Dean Ornish of California clearly shows that SSY is a proven technique yielding a tremendously higher benefit at a much lower cost. There were no dropouts in the SSY program against 4% in the honors program. In SSY, the average percentage reduction was 6% against 4% in the Dean Honors program. The maximum reduction was 25% against 10% in the Dean Honors program. The naked eye reversal was 50% against 0% for the Dean Honors program. The cost difference too is incomparably low. The heart patients who attended the 21-day joy therapy of SSY feel energetic within days, and within a few weeks to months, one can begin to see the blocks opening up and subsequent reversal of heart disease.
ಅಂಗಡಿ ಅಂತೇಳಿ ಗದಗ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ಟ್ ಸೇರ್ ತಾಲೂಕು ಹೇಳುತ್ತೆ ಗ್ರಾಮದಿಂದ ಬಂದಿದ್ದೇನೆ. ಹುಬ್ಬಳ್ಳಿ ಡಿವಿಜನ್ ಇಂದ ನಾನು ಫಸ್ಟ್ SSI ಪಡೆದೆ. ನಾನು ಅದು SSI ಪಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಬಂದ ನನಗೆ ಅಂದರೆ ಬ್ರೇನ್ ಟ್ಯೂಮರ್ ಅಂತೇಳಿ ನನಗೆ 2005 ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಎಂಡ್ವರೆಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಾಯ್ತು. ಆ ಮೂಮೆಂಟ್ನಾಗೆ ನನಗೆ ಫುಲ್ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಬರಲ್ಲ. ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಏನೇನಾದ್ರು ಇಲ್ಲ, ನೀನು ಏನು ಯಾವುದೇ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ಒಳಗೆ ಎರಡು ದಿವಸ ಅಥವಾ ಒಂದು ವಾರದೊಳಗೆ ನೀನು ಡೆಫಿನೆಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಸಾಯ್ತಿ ಅಂತ ಡೆತ್ ಸರ್ಟಿಫಿಕೇಟ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ರು. ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಅಂಥ ಮೂಮೆಂಟ್ನಾಗ ನನಗೆ ಸರ್ಜರಿನೂ ಆಯಿತು, ಗಾಮಾ ನೈಪು ಆಯಿತು. ಇಷ್ಟಿಲ್ಲ ಆದರೂ ಒಂದು ಕಡಿಮೆ ಅಂದರೆ 80 ಲಕ್ಷ ರೂಪಾಯಿ ನಾನು ಖರ್ಚು ಮಾಡಿದೆ. ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು ಸಹಿತ ನಿಮೆನ್ಸ್ ಬೆಂಗಳೂರಿಲಿ ನಾ ಟ್ರೀಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ತೊಗೊಂಡು ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಏನು ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು ನನಗೆ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಆಗಲೇ ಇಲ್ಲ. ನಾನು ಯಾವಾಗಲೂ ಒಂಥರ ಶವದಂತೆ ಇದ್ದೆ ಆ್ಯಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಹೇಳಬೇಕಂದ್ರೆ. ಆ ಒಂದು ಮೂಮೆಂಟ್ನಾಗ SSY ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಹುಬ್ಳಿ ಆ ಡಿವಿಜನ್ ಒಳಗೆ ನನಗೆ ಅದು SSY ಅಂದರೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿದ್ದಿಲ್ಲ. ಆ ಮೂಮೆಂಟ್ನಾಗ ನನಗೆ ಒಂದು 3-4 ಜನ ನನಗೆ ಆ್ಯಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಸಪೋರ್ಟರ್ ಆಗಿ ನಾನು ಕರ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹೋದರು. ಆ ಅಲ್ಲಿಂದ SSY ಪಡೆದು BST ಪಡೆದು ಆ ಒಂದು ಇದರೊಳಗೆ ನನಗೆ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಸಪೋರ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಯಾವುದಂದ್ರೆ ಪ್ಯಾರಲೈಸಿಸು ಸಹಿತ ಆಗಿತ್ತು. ಅಂಥ ಒಂದು ಸಮಯದೊಳಗೆ ನನ್ನಷ್ಟಕ್ಕೆ ನಾನು ಒಂದು ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಬರೀಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಬರ್ತಿದ್ದಿಲ್ಲ. ನಾನು ಒಬ್ಬ BST ಗ್ರ್ಯಾಜುಯೇಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಅಂಥ ಒಂದು ವಾತಾವರಣ ಇದ್ರು ಅಂತ ಸ್ಥಿತಿ ಒಳಗಿದ್ದಾಗ SSY ಮತ್ತು BST ಮಾಡಿ ನಾನು ಪುನಃ ಸಹಿ ಮಾಡುವಂತ ಒಂದು ಶಕ್ತಿ ಗುರುಜಿ ಒಂದು ಇದರಿಂದ ಪಡೆದೆ. ನಾನು ಪುನಃ ಇಷ್ಟೇ ಅಲ್ಲದೆ ನನ್ನ ಬ್ರೇನ್ ಟ್ಯೂಮರ್ ಸೈಜು ಸಹಿತ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಕೇಳಿ ಹಾಸ್ಪಿಟಲ್ ಬೆಳಗಾವ್ ಒಳಗೆ ತೋರಿಸಿಕೊಂಡಾಗ ಅವರು ನೀ ಎಷ್ಟೇ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು ಸತೆ ನಿನಗೆ ಏನು ಲೈಫ್ ಲಾಂಗ್ ನೀನು ಮನೆಯೊಳಗೆ ಇರುವಷ್ಟು ದಿವಸ ಊಟ ಮಾಡಿ ಹೋಗೋದು ಅಷ್ಟಪ್ಪ, ನಿನಗೆ ಇದೇ ಒಂದು ಸರ್ಟಿಫಿಕೇಟ್ ಕೊಡಕ್ ಸಾಧ್ಯತೆ, ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ತಿಂದು ಏನು ಕೊಡಕ್ಕಾಗಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಬೆಂಗಳೂರಿಗೆ ಅದೇ ರೀತಿ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರು. ಅಂತ ಒಂದು ಸಿಚುವೇಶನ್ ಗುರುಜಿಯವರು ಒಂದು ಮಾರ್ಗದರ್ಶನ ಮುಖಾಂತರ ನಾನು ಬೀರೂರೊಳಗೆ 10 ತಿಂಗಳ ಹಿಂದೆ ಕಾಯಕಲ್ಪ ಇದೇ ಒಂದು ಕಾಯಕಲ್ಪ ಕ್ರಿಯೆಯೊಳಗೆ ಭಾಗವಹಿಸಿ ಇವತ್ತು ನಿಮ್ಮ ಎದುರುಗಡೆ ಆವಾಗ ನನ್ನ ನಿಲ್ಲಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಸಹಿತ ಆಗದಂತ ಸ್ಥಿತಿ ಇತ್ತು. ಅಂಥದ್ರೊಳಗೆ ನಂದು ಟ್ಯೂಮರ್ ಸೈಜು ಸಹಿತ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಪಾಂಪ್ಲೆಟ್ ಒಳಗೆ ಹಾಕಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಫುಲ್ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಆಗಿದೆ. ಆ ಸೈಜು ಸಹಿತ ಇವಾಗ ಸೈಜ್ ತೋರಿಸಿದ್ದಾವೆ. ಅಂಥದೊಂದು ಡೆತ್ ಸರ್ಟಿಫಿಕೇಟ್ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟಾಗ ಬರ್ತ್ ಸರ್ಟಿಫಿಕೇಟ್ ಪುನಃ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಗುರುಜಿ ಅವ್ರು ಕೊಟ್ಟು ನಿಮ್ಮನ್ನು ನಿಲ್ಲುವಂತ ಒಂದು ಆಶೀರ್ವಾದ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ.